Hey guys, what's up? I'm here in front of Whittier School, which is now Arts Magnet. This is where I went to school for kindergarten through third grade, and this is where I folded my first cootie catchers and paper airplanes. And it also has very nice white walls. Perfect to show you this really cool model. Check it out. It is $1 shirt and tie that can fly, Flickr style. Whoa. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. This is my slightly modified version of Stefan Delecat's shirt and tie, which he has on his Flickr page. Check the description below for that link. This version has a thicker collar, and it also has some thickness at the top of the tie instead of coming to a point. And I've added some precreases and guidelines into the folding sequence that make the model easier to fold cleanly. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a US $1 bill, but you could also use any 3x7 rectangle. And I have a tutorial here for how to make two roughly 3x7 rectangles from a single square. All right, so let's begin face side up and let's turn over right to left. In other words, face side down. And let's fold in half. So fold this edge to the top. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Okay, now let's rotate, and let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And let's turn over, and let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. Okay, now we're going to fold this corner to right here, but just make a little crease mark right there. And unfold. And now let's fold this corner to the crease mark. And once again, let's make a little crease mark. And unfold. And let's fold this corner to the crease mark. And this time, just make a light fold like that. Now, let's fold this corner to here. So it's like that. And let's make the fold. And now we can unfold this flap, and now we're going to squash this flap. So let's reach into this pocket, and we're going to squash it down, and try to squash it evenly. And the way that you can squash it evenly to check if you're even is, let's turn over. And you want to make sure that this line aligns with this center line. So it's like this. And flatten. And let's turn back over. And now let's fold this edge to the middle, right to this line. And rotate, and let's fold this edge to here. Crease everything really sharply, and let's unfold the reverse fold. And unfold this flap and turn over. So it's like this. And now let's fold this flap up right on this line. And rotate. And now we're going to make a pleat right on the existing precreases. So there's the mountain, and right next to it is the valley. And there's the pleat, and you can flatten it like this, however it flattens. Okay? And let's do the same thing on this side. So make the mountain and the valley, and flatten it however it flattens. Okay, so this is what it should look like. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And let's fold it underneath the tie. This is the tie. So it's like that. And let's do the same thing on the other side. Let's fold this edge to here and go underneath the tie. Okay, so this is the tie and this is the shirt. Now we're going to do a kind of tricky fold. Let's try to fix this up so that we don't have this change of color. So unfold here, and we're going to change this fold, just move it up. We want to make the fold go from this point to this point. So just pinch it. Like that. And now let's stick it back in under the tie. And you see this corner comes nicely up to the top of the tie. And it looks a lot cleaner. So let's do that again on this side. Unfold the flap, and let's alter this fold, bring it up so that it goes through this point. Like that, and stick it back underneath the tie. Okay, so crease everything nice and sharply. And now let's fold this edge to the bottom of the tie. And let's turn over top to bottom, and let's fold these two corners to these two corners, just on this flap. So those two corners line up, and these two corners line up, and make the fold. Okay, let's turn over, and let's fold this flap up, aligning it with this edge. And now let's open this flap, and we're going to make a fold that goes from this point to this point. So it's a diagonal fold on the top layer that goes from here right to where this crease hits this edge. So it's like that. And let's make another diagonal fold that goes from the same point to this point on the top layer. So it's like that. And let's do the same thing with this flap. So let's fold from here to this point on the top layer and from this point to here on the top layer. Okay, now let's close it back up. So let's fold this edge to here. Like this. Okay, let's unfold this flap and let's turn over. Ooh, the shirt's taking shape. And now we're going to fold this rear flap. Let's fold this edge up so that this corner goes to right here. And same on this side. This corner goes to here. Okay, so it's like that. And now let's unfold this flap and let's fold this edge to the crease that we just unfolded. Like that. And let's crease this one really sharply. Okay, now let's turn over right to left. And let's fold this corner up. We're folding it right to the crease, and we want the fold to extend to this point. Like that. And rotate. And let's repeat on this side. And if you want, it's actually a little bit better if these corners don't actually touch, since the tie has a little bit of thickness at the top. Let's just pull them apart about that much. Okay, and now let's rotate. Ooh, it almost looks like an elephant. A one-eye elephant. Okay, now let's fold this flap up so that these two corners touch these two points. And you can tell that they're touching by turning it over. And now you can see the corners should touch the top of the tie. Like that. And the last step is we just want to stick the tie underneath the collar. So that's underneath one collar and the other collar flap. So it's perfectly in place, just like that. And now just flatten everything, crease it sharply, and here you have the shirt and tie. And from the back side, it doesn't look very good. So let's just keep it on this side and continue creasing it sharply. And if you can get it really, really, really flat, then it'll make a very nice flicker. And to flick it, I recommend flicking it right there, holding right here and whap.
All right, so to flick this thing, it's basically like an ordinary flicker, and let's see how it flies. Whoa! All right, so there it is. Hope you guys enjoyed this model and were able to fold it and fly it, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.